aliens have had long enough to establish their peaceful enclaves within the city's centers. It's time we move in and show them the fight isn't over yet. We're deploying to hit a high-profile target, one that they won't be able to cover up so easily. Move to secure the target site and eliminate any hostile contacts in the area.
All right, everybody, welcome to the real start to our campaign for this Let's Play, Operation Gatecrasher. The mission that you receive if you play the campaign without the tutorial. By the looks of it, we have a squad comprised of at least three of the people that I've created. We have at least Tom Fox, also known as Yoga Pants. We have Steven Apex, also known as Shorty. And what looks to be Lexi, who was our psyop soldier, or our psychic soldier from the last game. So that's interesting. I think the fourth person is a random, but I might be wrong about that.
Menace 1-5, we have a fix on the target. Move to place the X-4 charges at the designated position.
Alright, so let me confirm this. Yep, the last chick is Fumiko Yamazaki. Everybody else is Lexi, Shorty, Yoga Pants. That's very interesting. I think Lexi was the only person I made in my character pool who is designated to be a psyops, or to be found as a psyop soldier. But I instead have her as one of my beginning
These
troops.
These guys make up the bulk of the Advent forces we've dealt with. They're disciplined and well-equipped, but their obedience makes them predictable.
So that's very interesting. We're going to move upwards.
Moving out.
Could we hit them from this position?
Heading to that location.
Oh, I didn't move Tom all the way up to the thing. Okay, Tom. I'm sorry, Tom. This time, maybe you'll live. We have 85% chance to hit there.
Static covered.
We're gonna put people on overwatch. And we're gonna start opening fire immediately, because this is a pretty good advantage point.
I'm on it.
Because, I mean, hello, high ground! But I could also wait till the next turn.
Scanning.
We're gonna wait till the next turn. Alright, that's much better. Because I would like to be able to fire with everybody if possible.
Roger. Got my eyes on scanning.
Alright, we are gonna go for the 85% chance. Although both of them are 85% chance, so we're going for the one who's the furthest away from everybody else, because this guy might run to the left, and if he runs to the left, if he runs to his left, our right, he'll get shot. Surprise! It's the real beginning to the hostilities.
We're busted!
Oh shit, there's someone in the building! And here it goes. One down, two down. I guess three.
Hostiles pacified. Let me try to here.
Effective. So one thing that's really cool is the fact that Overwatch no longer overlaps, which was something that was very annoying in the last game. If you had like five people on Overwatch and one enemy ran into the room, all five of them would shoot him, which sucked. Now, obviously, they still have it so they'll still shoot at the same person if they legitimately can only see one person running into the room. But now if there's like three people coming, they'll divide their shots, and that's good.
Moving out.
All right, we're gonna give her full cover.
Menace 1-5, you're near the target position.
The question is, where are the enemies going to come from now?
Copy that!
We've dealt with a normal group of Advent soldiers, but what about the Advent soldier group? They'll probably have officers. We'll find out.
Affirmative. Moving out.
Ooh. Oh, shit. From the get-go, we got a PCS for superior conditioning. +3 HP. Oh, that's really good.
That guy's gonna love this.
All right.
On Overwatch.
So what PCSs are basically little buffs that you can put on your soldiers. And so that one's gonna be pretty useful. I'm probably gonna stick it on whoever ends up becoming my ranger. Or maybe I should put it on my heavy specialist, my grenadier. I'm gonna put it on my rangers because my rangers keep on getting in really bad scenarios.
Closing on target position now.
I'm on it. Moving to designated coordinates.
Come get some. Overwatch.
What do you mean you can't go on Overwatch?
Scanning.
What the fuck?
Quiet. You hear something?
I did it manually and it was, or I did it by using the icons and it was like, yep, this works. But if you use the hotkey, no.
Heading to that location.
Hey, we found the other group of people.
The Advent officers seem more capable than the grunts. We're not sure whether to chalk it up to training or stricter mind control.
Well, what I'll chalk things up to is a very well-placed grenade. Ah, crap. I was hoping I'd be able to hit both of them with this. Okay, how are we gonna do this? We are in a pretty bad position. Because everybody's really far away. So what I'm gonna do is actually fall back. Rather than stay up here, is there a full cover I can take cover behind? I'll go here.
That's affirmative.
Because I feel like making them push upwards towards us is a little bit of a safer bet.
Order's confirmed. Moving out. Moving over.
I don't want to have another scenario where one of my guys is just really out of position and he's just getting hammered by every single enemy there.
Heading to that location. Got it covered.
Yes! Let the officers succumb to absolutely nothing! There you go, that's something.
Target's still up!
Well, he has a flank. Ooh, but he didn't take advantage of the flank. He marked Lexi. Which probably does something annoying, like increases damage she takes. Oh, thank God.
There's heavy fire in this zone!
It looks kind of, it has the same kind of holographic sight thing that you get from when you stuck holographic sights on other people. So maybe it also increases their aim? Lexi, it's your first mission. You're getting your ass kicked. Okay. If I go over here, I might be able to get a good flanking shot on someone. Okay. He's flanking that guy. I'd like to try my luck with this one. Because if I can kill the officer, that would obviously be very good. Yes! Perfect!
Enemy down!
And if you're gonna sit here and try and flank my people, I'm gonna go behind you and flank you, buddy. Fuck him up, Tom! Oh.
Adjusting aim.
Tom.
You're gonna need to reload soon.
Oh. Oh, Tom. Oh boy. Tom's in a little bit of a disadvantage.
Kill confirmed.
Well, here's what I'm gonna do. We're gonna put Lexi in a way, in an area where she's not gonna get shot. I was gonna risk her, but no, I'm good. I'd rather have this guy do 4 damage to Tom and have Tom get gravely wounded. Don't crit. Thank God.
Incoming over here! Find some cover!
Anyways, I'd rather not have everybody die. Or I would rather have Lexi not die. So it doesn't show me who got promoted already, but I don't think Fumiko got a solid shot off yet.
Orders confirmed. On the move.
Let's see. If I throw a grenade over there, things should be better. Granada! Oh, wait. I actually can destroy the cover. Although I can't get the hurt on him. That's fine. Cover is good enough. You are in a trouble spot. Okay. You're not in a trouble enough spot. I can see this clearly now.
Understood. Moving out.
Maybe Aphex can get a good shot up. Come on, Shorty. You got this. 74% chance. I guess your shots fall short, too.
It's still
God
moving.
Damn it, Aphex.
Running dry on ammo. Rolling.
I hope there's only two groups of enemies, because otherwise we're having some trouble with this one guy. Thank Christ. If every single one of them had
enemy
missed.
Down.
That would be bad.
Area is secure. We're not picking up any inbound contacts. Scanners are clear. -15, we have a limited window to act before Advent responds. We need to get those charges planted on the double.
Hey, you don't have a turn limit counter on, so I think we'll be fine.
-15, rendezvous at the extraction point. Status confirmed. Squad is clear. Detonating charge.
Well, for the first mission in our campaign here, one wounded soldier, maybe not that bad. Made most attacks. Shorty Aphex. But did he hit most of attacks? Apparently not, because Tom got the most damage. I'm interested to see who's going to end up being in our initial soldier pool. All the recruits down the line.
Not a single casualty reported, Commander. I hope all of our deployments go this well.
Don't casualties also include people who got injured? Because that's a casualty. She's fucked up. She almost died.
Operating some of our most advanced equipment, specialists deploy robotic drones on the battlefield that can be outfitted for combat or field medic duty.
Oh, that's cute. It has the camo on it too. Okay. Well, Tom gets to be our support for this time around. Maybe he'll be able to survive too. Well, longer than the last support
the
we had.
Ranger serves as our primary reconnaissance unit. Capable of moving independently in concealment while engaging enemies at close range.
So we're probably gonna get a spread of all our four typical things. What is up with this super close zoom in? It like makes her bald. It makes all women bald. But we're probably gonna get like Grenadier. Yep, there you go.
Serving as our demolitions experts, the Grenadiers provide heavy ordnance delivery whenever and wherever we need it.
And the person who's gravely wounded and won't be seeing action for 20 days is going to be our sniper once again.
Just like it sounds, our sharpshooters engage enemy targets with pinpoint accuracy from extreme range. They're also trained in pistol marksmanship for the occasional close encounter.
Well, you're not a sport this time, Lexi. So sorry. Well, hey, gravely wounded 9 days. That's not as bad as, like, 20 days, I suppose. And the only thing is, I don't know how to apply PCSs. I think I need a specific building for that.
Commander, to the research labs.
Yep, I know who you are already, buddy. Don't worry. All right. Let me go to the various different places. No research project active.
I've started to wonder how the Advent administration views our current band of renegades. Do they see us as an actual threat, or more of a nuisance?
We just blew up a giant statue. I feel like that's a good threat.
Commander.
Alright. We're gonna throw down research. Maybe modular weapons would be good. Being able to fly all the things I've been finding. I'm gonna be skipping these little cutscenes that we already know of. Obviously, there are gonna be tons of cutscenes we haven't seen yet, so oof. Gotta get them.
There's room for us to expand our facilities on board the Avenger, Commander, but we'll need more engineers to clear out space for construction first.
Alright, how are we gonna do this? I could get the Guerrilla Tactics School early on. Unlocks additional skills and benefits for our soldiers, including an increase in the number of soldiers we can take on a mission. That would be really nice. So I'm gonna go ahead and grab that.
We'll work on the new facility right away, Commander. I'll send word when it's up and running.
14 days, holy crap. We need an engineer as soon as possible.
I probably could have saved a lot of time repairing the ship's systems if we had any idea how to translate their language. Unfortunately, we don't come across many linguists out here.
Commander, good to see you on your feet again. Welcome to the bridge, the nerve center of our operation. The aliens have our entire world in their grip. Advent controls everything. Government, communications, industry, not to mention the military. And it's on us to take it all back. Resources and time are tight, Commander. It'll be up to you to decide how to best use both. The ship is yours.
It's a lot of pressure, Bradford. That is a lot of pressure.
While
okay.
We prepare for new operations and continue our research, we can pass time by scanning at sites like this one. On your order, we'll start our scans on the surrounding area.
Commander, one of our resistance contacts just tipped us off to a site that may be worth investigating.
Okay, so we've started off in New Arctic rather than India this time around. That'll be interesting considering how places are kind of spaced out. This kind of links to three different areas all on its own for context. But now I can see what the bonus for our thing is. It's gain intel. So should probably stay here sometimes, but we're going to want to grab supplies for this beginning area because I don't think intel is going to be super valuable just yet when I can't even spend it on anything. Obviously, it's going to be valuable once we get like black market and stuff.
Commander, the Avengers' remote scanning capabilities will help us search the area for clues or other resources. It's going to take some time, though. We've got a lot of ground to cover.
But we're going to focus on supplies.
I am sure you will find the results to be as intriguing as I do, Commander.
Do you have anything else? We could research magnetic weapons and focus down on that the entire month. Yeah, we're not going to do that. We're just going to focus on everything that's fast.
Valuable applications stemming from this technology. I'll have a report assembled as soon as the research is complete.
Strategic resource located.
Alrighty, although Advent conducts regular patrols throughout the region, pockets of resistance in the area remain. We reached out to the local resistance sources and they pointed out several buildings nearby that they've been stashing contraband in. They offered up what they could spare. 55 supplies, it's pretty solid. And then we could go over here for more rookies!
Avenger plotting new course.
But do I need rookies? We are literally at the beginning of the game. So I have probably plenty, let me look. If we look at my soldiers, I currently have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 more rookies. And two of them are familiar faces. We got Quick Shot. Maybe we'll have a proper start this time around. And Nuke, the person who was our heavy whose rocket was a little bit too huge for us to use most of the time, because it would end up hurting us or blowing up the shit that we wanted to collect. Well, at least grenades aren't as deadly as rockets. I'm pretty sure there are still going to be rockets later on, though.
Hello, Commander. Work is well underway, but it will be some time yet before my research is complete.
What can I do for you, Commander?
Okay, I'm gonna go for gaining intel rather than going for these rookies, because I just don't need those particular rookies at the moment.
Setting course for the Arctic territories.
Whereas intel, we're probably gonna want it. I wanna see how this works. So how much intel do we actually gain?
As the resistance
we'll find out not
grow,
now.
We'll have a better chance of finding openings to strike back at Advent. As
Dr.
it is,
Ji
we've
Yong
already
Kwan.
Identified a potential target to disrupt the aliens' operations in this region. Our window of opportunity is limited, so we'll have to move fast.
Alright, well, engineers are good. We definitely need to accelerate build times for everything. And also even be able to actually access places. Oh my god, look at Ulrich. He's rocking it out. He looks like Spike. But we're not using you. We're gonna grab... Quick shot, Archie Robertson!
Deployment.
We've traced the location of an Advent data vault through their network to a facility situated in this region. As far as we can tell, it's storing data critical to the aliens' latest operation. We're moving in to seize control of the assets, but security forces in the area won't make it easy on us. Eliminate all targets and capture whatever you can.
Roger that, Central. All right. Neutralize all enemy targets. Recover reconnaissance footage from the Advent facility. Ooh, I'm hyped. I'm ready to get this shit started.
Menace 1-5, we've got a bead on the Advent data vault near your position. Be advised, self-detonating charges are in place at the target. Move to disarm and extract the package before its contents are destroyed.
Alright, so there's 8 turns until this thing is destroyed. Which means I am gonna have to rush up a little bit. But not as hardcore as I did in the past. I need to watch out for windows.
To access the Advent network from here. We might be able to hack their systems and get an advantage. But be careful. If they detect us, things will only get worse.
Alright, we have a slight problem. And that slight problem is, there's a not a terminal, there's a sensor tower right to our right. So I can't sneak past that area. I actually have to go this way instead. Where's the door? Oh, this is the door. We're probably going to... We're gonna go through the rooftop.
Orders confirmed. Moving out.
Because at the very least, I figured they can just jump down from anywhere and avoid this little place. I want to see what's in the streets. Whoa, really? No one in this immediate area? That's a solid plus. But I believe I did hear footsteps, so I'm not celebrating just yet. Fuck it. I guess we'll just go there.
Trying to plot out your routes? Too bad.
10-4.
There's gotta be enemies somewhere around here. Aha!
We've been spotted.
Shit! They were literally underneath my character.
Although they bear some resemblance to the sectoids first encountered during the invasion, their genetic structure now includes human DNA. They are stronger than ever, with an even greater psionic potential.
This is highly unfortunate.
Good copy.
This is why you don't dash, people. This is desperately why you don't dash. All right. She should be able to get a good shot on this Advent trooper, but let's see what this guy can do. Tommy, what do you have a chance for? You have a 33% chance on that guy because he's in high cover. Then we're gonna just shoot. We're gonna shoot with her. It just works out a little bit better.
I'm on the move.
Alright. With 4 people looking down at this sectoid, it should not have as much of a chance to wreck our shit. But let's not, you know, jinx ourselves. Mind control or disorientation? What are you doing? Probably mind control. Reanimation? Oh. It was looking at Apex and I was standing there going, oh boy. Apex is being mind controlled.
The aliens have found a way to mind control them now.
Okay, how are we gonna do this? I have an 84% chance on the zombie. Not shooting the zombie, though. Okay, good damage. Very good damage. Now we need to move up Tom and see if he actually is capable of shooting. Hey!
Headed there now.
I don't think we need to worry about the sensor towers after we've already been revealed.
Good riddance.
I'm not entirely sure, though. I just feel like the sensor tower would obviously call in reinforcements. But we don't know. Alright, we're gonna play it safe.
On my way.
We're not gonna dash. I'd like to be able to fire in the same turn that I move.
Moving to Overwatch. Rolling.
Yeah, we're not even gonna bother hacks
moving
because we've been seeing how that's been going. With because of these turn rushing things, I'm unable to go, do I want to fight against the reinforcements? Because obviously, no, because I need to do some shit.
On my way. Orders confirmed, on the move.
I'm a little bit more fine rushing up my people who are way, way, way in the back. Because it's not like they're going to be able to get a good shot off by slowly walking up to places super far away from everybody.
Move, move, move!
Alright, let's see what the sensor tower does when we actually run through it. Nothing. Alright, so legitimately it just gets you out of concealment.
On Overwatch. Affirmative, covering now. Roger that.
Oh, shit!
Menace 1-5, this is Avenger. We have positive confirmation of the target package. Move to acquire.
They're right around the corner! They're right around the fucking corner! Oh, no! Where are you guys going? Well, 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 this is interesting. I just wanted to hack that. And I guess we're gonna have to do some damage. Okay. If I move to this door, I should be able to get a good shot off. At least that's what we're hoping for.
Moving on target.
Open the door. Tactical maneuvers. Let's do this. All right, 61% chance to hit the sectoid. Rumble time. 4 damage, that's all enough. Anybody else capable of seeing this guy? Not from that many ideal locations.
Roger that.
Maybe I can throw a good frag in there. Not really. It wouldn't even reach his cover. It'd just land on the rooftop or something. Alright. Well, fuck it. 26% chance shot. Let's go. Didn't hit, but that's fine. I didn't expect him to.
Target's still up.
Well, looks like we're just gonna try and take our 64% chance. Didn't work. Oh, Jesus Christ, Tom.
Not good.
Well, then we're just gonna leave some people on standby on Overwatch. Just in case this guy tries to get a flanking shot.
Affirmative, covering now.
Oh god.
Advent troop spotted.
Well, it's a good thing we still have 3 turns until we have to do anything, and we're right in front of it. Aw, you panicked him, you- or her, shoot. I was hoping for a mind control. Oh! 8 damage critical, holy fuck. That guy is double the dead.
Menace 1-5, the clock is ticking. That detonator isn't going to wait. Get to the vault and disarm it before we run out of time.
Yeah, no, I get- Okay, alright. Problems. Many problems are being had here. We need to get indoors or on this rooftop. Alright. She's fucked. There's nothing we can do for Famico. Oh, no. This is a laser barricaded window. I didn't know that. Fuck. Well, I have to debate things. I have to debate things. We're gonna leave Fumiko out here alone, or I could try and get a flanking shot on this guy.
Moving.
We're gonna try and do
location.
That. Because I don't want Fumiko to get screwed over because of the panic. Please land this! Fuck you! Shit. Okay. Alright. Well, bad spot. Bad spot. What are my chances to hit? Shitty. Can I throw a grenade through the window? I can. Alright, we're just gonna dash towards this door. Or I could try hacking this thing right now. I'm gonna try hacking this thing right now.
Infiltrating access point.
That way I don't have to run up and get screwed over by these guys at the front. I know we're gonna get reinforcements in the back. I don't know if they attack on the same turn they land in, though. I just wanna get this out of the way so I'm not constantly rushing. Okay, now we can focus on the killing rather than the rushing.
Menace 1-5 acknowledged. The package is secure. Be advised, reinforcements are inbound. Eliminate all hostiles threatening the AO.
This is really, 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 really bad. We are currently engaged with 6 enemies.
We've got Advent here!
Maybe even 7.
Get set!
At least we shot the officer! And actually hit him too! Wow! Oh boy. And great, now he's flanking Tom. I'm sorry, Tom.
I'm pinned down here!
At least they get RNG'd too sometimes.
I'm alright.
So what we're gonna have to do, we're gonna have to rush the chick in. We're gonna have to rush Famico in. And probably blade this sectoid so she doesn't just get instantly murdered. At least that's my general plan. Or I can move her up point blank range, get a shot off. Oh, she doesn't have any bullets left. Fuck, no, okay. We're gonna have to slash it. I obviously also want to see what the hell this thing is on the ground. Oh, fuck me! Famico, you fuck lord!
Adjusting aim.
Who's the closest to this damn item? I want it. I need it. Can Aphex make it down there and grab the item while still being in cover? Yes.
Move, move, move!
It better be damn worth it. It is a... Ooh! Absolutely worth it. Another plus one HP thing. Or, well, a health increasing item. All right. We need to move our people in positions where they're not going to be immediately fucked by like the 5 people outside.
Roger that.
And that means making some really irrational, dodgy kind of movements and hoping for the best. I can't shoot this same turn.
Go, go, go!
I'm probably being questioned like hell, like, no, Gom, don't make that particular move. It's going to leave your character out in the open. And I understand completely. Oh.
There's heavy fire in the zone.
She's fucked, by the way. She's going to get flanked by the soldiers in the back. Which would be an acceptable loss if she had fucking killed the sectoid. Come on, Famiko. At least she's in half cover. There's the reason how come I didn't stick her like directly in front of the sectoid. Oh, I thought he was shooting at Tom. I was like, damn, that's a bold maneuver. You're really far away to be making a high cover shot like that. All right, here's how we're gonna handle this particular scenario. We have an 88% chance to shoot this fuck base. In the face. So we're gonna reload. And we're gonna shoot it.
Ready to engage.
The 88% chance went to a 56% chance, but you take what you can get.
Target neutralized.
Alright. Now what we can do is we could shoot a grenade at these two. So that way, we have a little bit more of a guaranteed chance to kill them if we land a shot on them. So I'm gonna take it. Ooh, 4 damage for one of them, okay. I don't like doing that, but we have so many people attacking us at the moment that we might as well.
Closing on target position now.
Apparently I had a flanking shot on somebody. Oh, I had a flanking shot on that guy?! Ooh. Well, I would have loved to have taken that one. I still have a flank shot, though. Okay, all right. We're taking it. I destroyed the cover of the building. And that worked out to a hidden advantage that I didn't know was there.
I'm running low on ammo.
You tried, Robertson. You tried.
Get it together!
So by the looks of it, when you reload on the same turn, it reduces your aim chance. That's interesting. I didn't know that was a thing that happens. Because an XCOM Wait a Minute Within, if you reloaded at the end of your turn, period. So I guess they're like, yeah, we need a trade-off somewhere. Oh no, they have grenades too! Fuck! That's karma, I suppose. That's karma for me. All right. How are we gonna handle this scenario? I could sword slash this guy, or I could shoot him in the face with a shotgun. I'm gonna shoot him in the face with a shotgun.
Understood. Moving out.
Oh, he's on Overwatch, right. Fuck! At least he missed. Here, have a 71% chance of getting shot in the face! Fucking XCOM, man. Fucking XCOM.
Come on, focus.
Okay. You know, I have grenades too, assholes. I can blow you all up. I can blow us all up, all at once. I'm gonna go up. That's where I'm going. Up.
I'm all over it.
Can't shoot my two out person if they're nowhere close. Alright, how are we gonna do this? I don't have a lot of decisions. I could throw a grenade. We're just gonna reload. Alright. Reload and find out who I can shoot for a high chance. 45% chance to hit the guy right in front of me. Let's try it again, Robertson. I think he missed. Son of a fuck ass! We missed all our shots on these guys! This isn't as bad of a scenario, but we're not landing our fucking shots! Because we need, like, 78% or some shit.
Heading out.
Okay, Apex. For the love of all Christ, land this 84% shot, or I'm sending you into more deaths as if you're a ranger. Thank you. Thank you. He's gonna get flanked and probably die. But it's tough shit. It's just, this is a bad scenario. And there goes the flanking shot. You and your one health, asshole. Goodbye, Apex. Apex, your short height has kept you alive today.
They got me flanked!
You're shooting at me? Ow!
I'm pinned down here!
Is this full cover? I'm surprised he can even see me from here. Perspective is a bitch. Alright. We need you to be the dead. The very deads.
I'm on the move.
How do you like my flank?
How did you fucking miss that?
Don't you fucking taunt me, buddy! Your eyes are huge! And you've been missing most of your goddamn shots, too!
Position confirmed.
Robertson, for once in your goddamn life, land a shot. Thank you. I call you quick shot. The only thing you're quick to do is miss constantly. Apparently I could possibly get a shot off from here. We're not gonna risk that just yet. Okay. Oh, much better.
Target down.
Status confirmed. All hostiles are down and the area is secure. Status confirmed. Mission accomplished.
That was so many goddamn Advent Troopers. Holy shit. And apparently Fumiko is amazing. Dealt most damage, made most attacks, and was the most under fire. Well, that's what happens when you're... No, she got panicked. She got panicked and ran outside into the worst possible position. But she at least got a kill while she got panicked, which always makes me happy. I'm always happy when a person panics, and rather than just hiding in a corner, they go, "Oh god, I got a kill!" And they get it. It's a happy time. So we get any promotions? I hope we did. I think every single person deserves one. Yep, there you go. Alright. We're gonna give Tom medical protocol, because being able to heal two people is obviously gonna be pretty good. I could also go for combat protocol. Having that guaranteed damage might make up for all the times where we're like, "Oh god, there's a sectoid! I need to kill it! Oh god, it's not dying! Why is it not dying?" But I also want medkits. God damn it. I can't avoid the want. The need. Keep people alive. Shredder's gonna be good for the armor targets, so that's kinda like for later. Hardly within a month, and we gotta fucking deal with turrets and robots. I could also make him demolitions expert by making him super tanky. Granting him a bonus plate, a point of armor. Which means he takes one less damage per turn. And with the PCS buff, he could end up having 7 health from the get-go. Or really, like, 6. Or not 6, 8. Because once you reach, the more you get promoted, the more health you have. I really want to focus on those damages, man. It's a bad idea, but it's going to keep happening. Also, that's hilarious. Archie becomes a sniper. Again.
Hello, Commander. The council you once knew is no more. Its membership
have all sworn loyalty to the Advent Administration. With one exception. It is good to see you again. In the days since your capture, I have done all I can to aid the Resistance from the inside. It was these Resistance operatives that provided the intel leading to your recent extraction. As of now, Resistance forces are currently somewhat disorganized. If we are to defeat Advent and their alien masters, you must change this before it is too late. What you are seeing are classified reports of missing civilians from across the world. Their numbers are growing. We suspect they have been taken to a nearby Advent black site, though its exact location.
New objective added.
All right, we gotta try and contact the Resistance in the Blacksite region.
Hello, I'm keeping tabs on all our operations, Commander. Our people are standing by for your orders.
We still don't know what's gonna be at the Blacksite, but we'll find out soon enough.
Now that we have more staff on the engineering team, we can start clearing out space for new facilities, Commander. We should keep looking for more recruits, though. We'll need them to staff the facilities once they're built.
So being a VIP for XCOM is apparently a really stressful job. That's all we're learning from this, because everyone keeps on balding.
We're picking up an unsecured transmission from some clown calling himself Van Dorn. Doesn't sound like the kind of recruit we're looking for.
Van Dorn? The fucking VIP we had to rescue once? Yeah, no, we're good. We're good. He'll kick some alien ass in his own time. At least that's what I feel like that's who he was. Van Dorn, the guy who I accidentally had confused for Thorn.
We have a lead on the alien black site, but we'll have to rely on the local Resistance to actually get us into the facility. We should try to make contact with their forces in the region as soon as possible. It's the only way we're going to find out what's behind this so-called Avatar project.
We're gonna keep on just trying to gain intel and building stuff up. I need to send my engineer somewhere first. Alright, so...
I appreciate you recruiting new staff for the engineering team, but as it stands, we have people still waiting for an assignment. We can have them working on construction, staffing a facility.
Yeah, shush, I just did it. Don't worry. I knew that there was somebody who needed to be placed somewhere.
These findings will likely prove crucial to our ongoing efforts, Commander.